morning, I just want to share this few words with you as a devotional this morning. And let me start by reading this. Dr. G. Campbell Morgan said that the cycle in Genesis is generation, degeneration, and regeneration. And we can see through the degeneration that Cain killed Abel, but God gave Seth to continue the divine line. The earth became violent and evil, so God eliminated humanity, but chose Noah and his family to carry out his work. From the pagan Ur of the Chaldeans, God called Abraham and Sarah and gave them a son, Isaac, and the future of God's plan for salvation lay with that son. Isaac and Rebekah had two sons, Esau and Jacob, but God rejected Esau and chose Jacob to build the 12 tribes of Israel and inherit the covenant blessings. And basically, that's a very, very small way in how we can put Genesis. It's all about God bringing up the nation of Israel. But before we even get to the end of the book, we understand that generation was what God did in chapters 1 and 2. Degeneration is what happens to Adam and Eve when they fall, when they fell and disobey God. And because of that is what we live the way we live now. We have so many things going on happening in this world, naturally and spiritually, morally. This world it's going sideways and it's happening so rapidly, and men just don't want to come before the Lord. But let's look at verses 8 through 13 in chapter 3 of Genesis, and this happens after they have fallen into that trap of Satan, and they disobey the Lord, they fall into sin, and that was in verses 1 through 7, and then we get through 8 through 13. Now God is coming towards them, and he's going to confront them. He's going to confront Adam and Eve, and he goes like this, verses 8, and they heard the sign of the Lord, God walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, where are you? And he said, I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked. I hid myself. He said, who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree of which I commanded you not to eat? The man said, the woman who you gave to be with me, she gave me fruit of the tree, and I ate. Then the Lord God said to the woman, what is it that you have done? The woman said, the serpent deceived me, and I ate. And I just want us to meditate a little bit on one question that God is asking, and is the first question that God is asking to this humanity that he created, and now they disobeyed him, and they became enemies of God. Now they're friends with Satan. So God is coming to confront them from their sin that they committed. And he is coming as a parent comes. And I don't know about you guys, but being in this pandemic, we miss those relationships with our relatives. And it's awesome to have them and enjoy them. And we haven't seen our granddaughter for the longest time. One of these days she came and she stayed overnight. And we're playing hide and seek. And it's so funny because they go and they hide under or behind this sheet or anything that they can find. But it's so obvious for parents, and you know where they are. And you start counting them and you go, here I go. And you go and find them and they're right there. And you know that they're there. But we tend to do this. Where are you? Where are you, Violet? Where are you? Knowing where they are. And God is doing the same thing here. Verses 9, he goes, where are you? And that's a rhetorical question. God is asking Adam, where are you, Adam? What happened to you? Come to me, explain to me, tell me, what did you do? And obviously, the degeneration is depravity in men. God made us perfect through Adam and Eve, but they disobeyed the Lord, and sin came into the world through them, through one man. And that sin brought evil, brought death. And now God is confronting Adam and see what he's going to say. And again, it's a rhetorical question. Where are you? Not that God didn't know. But basically, God is giving Adam a chance, giving him an opportunity for him to confess and repent. And obviously, he wasn't going to do it. Romans 3:10 said that there is no one that does good. And throughout the Bible, we understand and we read a lot about how man is constantly evil. In chapter 6 of Genesis, verses 5, we find those words where it says that man is thinking and doing evil all the time. And it's just incredibly so truthful that man alone cannot seek God. And so God comes after the rescue. God is the one that comes after us and try to amend things with us. We don't deserve it, but he's so merciful. And just like those parents that are playing hide and seek with their kids, God is coming towards us, knowing that where we are, knowing that we have failed him, knowing that we are sinners, knowing that we're going to continue to fail. But he wants to give us an opportunity to change. He wants to give us an opportunity for us to be that person that he had in mind for us. God wants us to help us to become like him. And for that, we need to obviously seek him first. Know him. And be able to live for him, glorify him, honor him, and do everything according to his will, not according to our will. But sin is, it's stopping us from doing that. And God is basically saying, where are you? I want to have a relationship with you, and you're hiding from me. Come to me, and I will give you life. And I just want you to meditate on those words. And for some of us that know the Lord, we understand that we need to be building that relationship with him. But for those that are probably listening to some of these devotionals and don't know the Lord, they might be confused and thinking, why do I want to have a relationship with the Lord? Not knowing that eternal life is at stake. And I just pray that we can be available and that God can do what he needs to do through us, because he loves us and he wants us to have that relationship with him. God bless you. Have a great day.